couch, dogs, me, guitar lessons.
Hey there, LickNRiffers! Welcome back to yet another awesome fingerstyle lesson here on LickNRiff, in which I will show you a very cool and simple method to create beautiful, haunting, Scottish-style, bagpipe-style solos. Okay, you only need two strings. Okay, strings one and two. But there are two very, very important key points, okay, which I will tell you right now, before we even start playing. Okay, you don't play them together. Okay, you don't play... Okay? You want to play it as a phlegm. A phlegm is a rhythmical concept, which means ta-da, okay? One note right after the other, okay, like this. The second string first and then the first string, okay? To get the, okay? That sound, the phlegm, okay? Ta-da. One note right after the other. The second string first with your thumb and then the first string with a finger. That's the second key point. To get the right dynamic, you need the thumb on the second string. Okay, so this might be a new experience for some of you. So, okay, play this. Okay, one after the other. Okay, thumb first and then the finger. Okay, for some reason I'm playing the third finger because I'm used to finger style, so I'm too used to this to change. Okay, but you can use the first finger. Okay? Okay? Everything creates different dynamics, so try the third finger as well. Okay, now the scale we're gonna use is the E major scale. Okay, and sometimes we'll reduce it to the E major pentatonic scale. So the E major scale on the first string is 0, 2, 4. Okay, you can use the phlegm right now on the second string. So 0, 2, 4, 5, 7, 9, 11, and 12. Okay, play the second string with each second note. And immediately it starts to get the right color. Now if you add a hammer-on to it, you get the right feel. Okay, 4-5-4, you can play a hammer-on and a pull-off. Okay, if you want the full line, pull it off to 0 as well. Okay, or to 2. Okay? Okay? Okay, fast. Okay, you can linger on the fourth fret. Okay? And this is why we're gonna reduce it to the pentatonic scale, because 5 and 7 don't really work, but 4 and 7 do. Okay, this is Scottish bagpipe. Okay, so when you go up, sometimes you want to play the 4 to 7, okay, which is the pentatonic line. Now, a higher pentatonic line would be 9 and 12. Okay, so you skip the 11, okay? Okay, this is too simple. Okay, and it doesn't really befit the style, so you skip the 11 most of the time. Sometimes for emphasis, to end the line, you want to play the two notes absolutely together, but... Okay, now this is why you don't play the third string, okay? You don't play the third string because it's a minor note. Now, if you want to cheat, okay, you can play an alternate tuning and tune the third string up to G sharp. Then you can use it, okay? But we're not gonna use it. I want to play it pure, okay? So the key here is, again, thumb for the second string, phlegm almost all the way, and a lot of hammer-ons and pull-offs, okay? Okay, practice it. You want to play hammer-ons and pull-offs very quickly. Okay? Okay? So 4-7-4, and then immediately 2, and then 2-4-2, and you can pull it down to 0. And then play the 0 twice, and then harmonize it with the second string. Okay? It's really easy to create pentatonic lines. Okay? You can use the 5. Just sprinkle it in there every now and then. Okay? See, this is not the style, so the 4 would have fit better. I played it on purpose. There you see? And remember, hammer on the notes as much as possible. Instead of 4 and 7, play 4-4, hammer on to 7. Okay? And then you can use the 11 if you play a line that justifies the 11. 9, 12, 11. Okay, I just played. Okay, or. Okay, I played a step up and then a step down the scale. And then. Okay, just a pattern, just a motif. Try to imagine fields. Try to imagine green fields. Okay? And if you have the third string tuned to G sharp, you can play it every now and then. Emphasis. Now the bagpipe sound is actually the drone, the droning B note. Okay, so you don't really need the G sharp on the third string. I was just glib. Okay, it's completely unjustified. Simple melodies. Don't overdo it. Keep it serene. Keep it, you know, meditative. Okay? Get into it. Five is very risky. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. You can pull after the zero, you can hammer on from the zero. Sorry. I made that mistake. Anyway, you can play 10 instead of 11. You can play 9 and 10, but just once. Okay, just once. Okay, just once to take it just outside for a moment and add that minor sound. See, you play it too much, it loses context, it loses its specialness. Just use it once. And just once at the right time. You can also do the same thing with 3 instead of 4. You can play 2 and 3 to get a minor sound. And then immediately go back to the major sound. Okay? I'll play it again. See? Just the very end. I'm playing 4, 2, and 0. And then I play 0 again. Okay, so... just once to sprinkle it in. So you can use the 10 once and the 3 once, but just, you know, at the very, when you feel that it's the right time. So go have fun with this. I'll see you in the next lesson. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. There are hundreds, literally hundreds of lessons for free waiting for you. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next lesson. Bye for now.